Remember yesterday how United States Ambassador to the United Nations Nikki Haley said the U.S. would be taking names of countries that supported a resolution critical of the Trump administration's decision to recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital? Well, let's hope Haley brought a lot of pens and paper, because 128 countries voted against the United States today, many of them U.S. allies. Only 9 countries voted with the U.S. There were 35 abstentions. Among the 128 countries that voted to condemn the U.S. on this issue were some countries with some rather questionable records of their own. Take Venezuela's representative today.
The world is not for sale. The world is not for sale, and your threats imperil global peace.
The U.S. imperils global peace, says the representative of Venezuela, a country in a humanitarian disaster, with violence in the streets, an economy in complete collapse, citizens malnourished, dying children being turned away from hospitals, starving families joining street gangs to scrounge for food. On what moral platform does the government of Venezuela stand today? Not to be outdone, of course, the U.S. also got an earful today from Syria. We're in the 7th year of the brutal Syrian civil war that has killed 500,000 people and displaced millions. Syrian President Bashar al-Assad has used chemical weapons against his own citizens, including children. Also feeling a bit preachy to get today, Yemen, which helped draft the resolution condemning the U.S., seemingly more focused, at least during the speech, on where the U.S. puts its embassy in Israel than on the 7 million Yemenis on the brink of starvation in that country's civil war.
In light of the sensitive circumstances that our region is experiencing and which constitute a threat to international peace and security.
Yemen concerned with stability in the region. Interesting. There are plenty of policies and actions that are perfectly valid to criticize about the United States and about Israel, and certainly whether this move will help the peace process in any way seems one of them. But listening to these countries, including North Korea and Myanmar and Turkey and China, lecturing the United States in any way about human rights and peace might seem a bit much. But here is a bit of context that you might not know. According to UN Watch, which monitors the United Nations, the United Nations General Assembly from 2012 through 2015 has adopted 97 resolutions specifically criticizing an individual country. And of those 97, 83 of them have focused on Israel. That is 86%. Now, certainly Israel is not above criticism, but considering the genocide of the Rohingya people in Myanmar, the lack of basic human rights in North Korea, the children starving in the streets of Venezuela, the citizens of Syria targeted for murder by their own leader using the most grotesque and painful of weapons, you have to ask, is Israel truly deserving of 86% of the world's condemnation? Or possibly is something else afoot at the United Nations, something that allows the representative of the Assad government to lecture the United States for moving its embassy?